What's up, y'all? Welcome back. So it is Saturday, June 19th, and we're here at Cradle of Humankind. So you're gonna be learning more about history in just a bit. So let me get my tickets. Alright, so we are about to go into the museum and cave right now. Are we about to get wet?
It says a little splash, but no.
This is more than a little splash.
They're taking us to the core elements, remember?
Yeah. Thank you. inside of a cave. So this is really breaking down. Thank you. Okay, well, humans have done
what we've managed to do, how we're able to exist with others, the development. And you know, years from now, we will be a part of history. It's like our ancestors from millions years ago.
Vehicles that we have created.
The tools that we have created for life to survive. For work.
These are the tools that we made. The rocks were used as tools. When technology didn't exist. Wow, that's amazing. I just want to say that donut looks really, really good. Even though it ain't no real donut. But yeah, this is just the gist of it, y'all. So I hope y'all liked it. If you're in South Africa, definitely check it out. It was only 100 rands. So there is a tour. And then there's the cave park. All right. So we're probably gonna head out of this here. It talks about the heat, but we're gonna head out. And we're supposed to be having some fun later on tonight, so y'all stay tuned. But I hope y'all enjoyed it. Definitely do your research, learn more about our history, how humans existed. Alright, so I'll see y'all in a bit. What's up, y'all? I am at Woodworks Cafe, and Huh?
In Rose Bank. And we about to eat. So right now, I just ordered a caramel hot chocolate. Right here. See it. And I just ordered some eggs, spinach, pork sausage, toast, and avocado. So I'm gonna let y'all see it in a bit. So y'all stay tuned. All right. So this is like a little open area, kind of like a mall slash shopping center slash market slash restaurant. And it's just a really nice open vibe. It's really nice. And this is in Rose Bank.
All right, y'all. So we got the toast, got the scrambled eggs, avocado, spinach, sausage.
Is that salad?
They call these chips, but they're really french fries.
Quite some salt.
The whole flight was just Yusundur and his entourage. He travels with like 50 people.
They put the smoked cheddar in here.
So we were just literally on his flight.
And I need my side of lemons. What's up, y'all? Welcome back to the Chase Business Channel. I don't know where I'm at, but I just took a road trip somewhere. Where are we at?
We're in Hazy View. In the Mpumalanga province.
There you go. Whatever she said. So we're gonna be here for 2 days, and I'm gonna give y'all a quick little tour of the place. So this is a cottage. And we paid 200 rands a day, which is like $120 US dollars a night here. But I just wanted to show y'all what you can get. We're like in the middle of nowhere, just about. So this is my room. I'm not going to show you the other one, but the other one looks exactly just like this here. So this is my bathroom right here. You can see the shower like so. It's a really big bathroom. This is like the sitting area right here. And I'm still in South Africa, y'all. So this is the bedroom here. Nothing too fancy, but it's really nice for what you get. This is a laundry room. What the heck? So there are no washers. Right here is the living room area. So we got a little fireplace, flat screen TV, living room. There is a outside area. I guess that's like the side door. Refrigerator. Ain't nothing in here, but it's a nice size refrigerator. There's hella space. There's a wine cooler, microwave. This like the dining room area. It's just like super big. And this is the kitchen area right here. Sink, outside view. This window is open, just so y'all know. Okay.
What happened?
That window is open. The windows are open, just so y'all know. But here's the best part right here, which is the outside view. So this is the table where we can have our breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Then like all of this, like there's a whole bunch of land, empty spaces. They do have some wildlife here. There's a impala, some chickens, a dog, and there could be some other wildlife here. Man, for $120 a night, this is a place where we might be grilling at. Might do some grilling. This is the side of the house. Here, this is a deck. And then lastly, we have a little miniature pool, which is like bomb. I don't even know how deep it is. It seems pretty deep. Alright y'all, so this is the tour of the place, so stay tuned, cause supposedly we have a surprise waiting on me, so I guess we're gonna be surprised together. So I'll see y'all in a bit. Alright y'all, so we are at the elephant sanctuary, so we're about to get the opportunity to see some elephants. Y'all are about to see some elephants. So this is our tour guide right here. And I'm gonna take y'all on this journey. So make sure y'all subscribe. Subscribe, y'all. Do me that favor, all right? Let me know you appreciate these things. So we about to do it right now.
Your ringers off?
Mm-hmm. How you feeling?
Don't wanna start off.
Yeah. How you feeling? Oh my gosh, it's two of them.
There might be more.
These are the two which we are looking after, and these two are orphans from the culling programs in the Kruger National Park. And we rescue them from different operations. So the names of them, there we have Kitso, K-I-T-S-O. Mm-hmm. It's a local language which is Tswana, being spoken in Northwest, and it means knowledge. 22 years old. Here we have Casper, the friendly ghost. 35 years old.
Wow.
So back in the 1986 in the 80s, Casper and his three brothers, they were bought by a German family. They gave individuals a chance to buy them. So he was bought by a German family with his two brothers, and the German family was staying in Namibia. They take the three boys to Namibia. They didn't plan about the future for them. So when they start to get into the teenager age, they became aggressive, showing their emotions that they are not getting enough food. And with the good sense of smelling, they discover that there's an orange farm which was 5 kilometers away from them. they pay them a visit. The visit for these gentle giants are expensive. The owner of that orange farm, you shoot one of them.
Mm.
The other one get electrocuted to death. Then he was left alone. And they put him on a hunting trophy. That is when he comes to the pitch of the sanctuary. So he said the sanctuary paid them, then they brought him back to South Africa.
So they put him on something where people could hunt him.
Yeah, and pay them. Mm.
Hmm.
So he said they paid them, then they brought him back to South Africa at the age of 18 years old.
Hmm.
Mm. And kids or his family used to cut. Wise man, do you have game pellets there? Okay, just a minute. Okay, then Kiso, his family was a huge family. It was a family of 60 elephants.
They How many?
60.
Huh?
So they used to come out of the park.
Ooh.
Going to Malela and Sugarcane Farms.
Okay.
Then the Kruger National Park decided to cull the big ones, leaving the young ones.
Why did Casper look like he was going to attack Kiso?
Casper is greedy. He doesn't want Kiso to get the other Lucerne there. So then the Kruger National Park decided to cull the big ones, leaving the young ones. The young ones, they were planning to sell them in Switzerland in a zoo so that they can compensate
Look at
the
them.
Farmers.
Look at Casper.
So then Switzerland, they started to make the zoo big. Then down this side, lions, they were taking advantage to them because they get protection from the mother. Mm. So he was left alone and the park asked us to rescue him. We rescue him at 4 years.
Mm.
And that's how we get them.
Oh.
Take it.
So we rescue him at the age of 4 years.
Mm.
Then we keep them in here if we have a booking. If maybe we could have get here maybe a little bit, maybe about 1:30, then we could have leave them to go for free feeding. So that they can go around the farm alone doing their free feeding. And if they want to swim, we have a big dam there whereby they can go and swim. And their digestive system is very poor. It makes them to eat a lot. They spend something like 16 to 19 hours eating and drinking clean water. It is because they have one huge stomach. They are different to other herbivores. Other herbivores, they are similar to a domestic cow. They are ruminants, they have four chambers. And if they are not, they have an advantage. Not to boy.
You want me to take a picture of you? Give them water?
Okay, if maybe there's anyone who would like to give them water.
Oh, yeah.
Water. So elephants, they have a good memory, they don't forget like us. Yeah, so it's better to be good friends than to be enemies. To be enemies for life.
It doesn't stop?
But
it'll just keep taking water.
Yeah, you can manage to hold about the 10 to 12 liters in each trunk.
Wow.
So yeah, they use the trunk to drink water. Get closer, a little bit closer. So they first is fill the trunk with water, then they'll pour into the mouth. So here on the forehead, there's a valve which is there to block the water not to pass.
Mm.
It is because the trunk, that is their nose, the sinuses which run the colon, is being separated by the septum.
Yeah.
So it's part of the hen. A sound amplifier for making sounds for communication is connected to the voice box. And when drinking water, they also use it. And it's only muscles pegged in the 100,000 of muscles in their time. Around 40 to 45 years, they get the 61. When they start to lose it, it's difficult to eat a balanced diet. So it forces them to walk down to river banks or swampy areas looking for salty food. The next thing, they starve to death. They can live for about 60 to 70 years. When they replace them, the new ones, they start from back. They develop from back, they push forward and up. This is how the old set to start to break out in front in small pieces until the whole set is fully developed. Chewing motion is grinding, forward, backwards, forward, backwards. Here it is the difference between the molars of African and Asian. The ridges are big for African, small and powerful for the Asian. Maybe it's because of different size. I'm not so sure why. And these are not real tusks. This is fiberglass. They were molded the same shape as the real ones of elephants which died in the Kruger National Park. So the real ones are in the Elephant Museum. The real tusk was weighing 43.9 kilograms. And this one, 29 kilograms. So which means this one is the one which was being used. If you look at this, at the tip of it, they look like the same. So they are more like humans being left or right handed. So if you'd like to know their dominating side, the shorter tusk, that's the dominating side of the elephant. This one is also fiberglass. It was molded the same shape as the front foot. The front foot is round in shape, and the big one is oval like a rugby ball or like an egg. They have 5 toenails in front. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 4 at the back foot. Underneath of the foot, same like underneath of our foot. Any sharp thing can get in like thorns. And it is very sensitive. It can detect a vibration from the ground. That's why in 2007 they survived the tsunami. By picking it 2 days before then, they all moved it to higher levels. So it's like earthquake, volcano, cyclones.
It's no, it was in Phuket, Thai. where was the tsunami? Thailand.
Indonesia.
Indonesia.
And they walk on tip of their toes. This one is a fibrous cushion pad. That's why we can't hear them when they walk. It works like a shock absorber. And it also helps them not to get stuck in mud. Okay, do you have any questions so far?
Nope.
Okay, so we can see that.
All right, so now the elephants are about to come to us. They about to let them out, and they're just going to interact with us, so we'll see.
Obviously, the sanctuary that the Manung is being used to look after them. So looking after elephants is expensive. Yeah, they eat a lot. So to give them 100% time to roam around the farm, these guys, they are destructive. Which means is they are going to live here for a short period. Then they will be no longer having food. So some food we have to buy, like lucerne. Fruits, give them some fruits, gempeles, so that we can balance it. Okay, there's a misty wise man this side. He is standing with Kito. Then that side we have Mr. Bevan standing with Casper. So for now, you are going to take turns to touch them. I don't know who is going to be the first one.
Go for it. Don't startle them.
Okay, you can come this way. You can be with Mr. Bevan. Hello. I can use that area for pictures. Where Swaz Nigga lives. That's what we know. We've never been there. We just know that he was a coming there.
Thank you.
You can use that area for pictures there.
Oh, thank you. Which one's older?
This one.
That's Casper.
All right, everybody say goodbye to the elephant. What's their names again?
Casper and Keito.
Casper and Keito.
Walking ahead. Casper's right here.
See you later, guys.
Wow, those things are huge.
Yeah, they are huge. They are not yet fully grown up. The males, they grow bigger than the females. They can reach about 10,000 kilograms.
Wow.
The female is 8,000 kilograms. That's 8 tons. 10 tons. So that's why it's now 6,000.
That's it?
Yes.